Today, the Living with Wildlife Illinois team is hosting a question and answer session about one of the rarer species in Illinois, the greater prairie chicken. I'm Laura Kamen.
And I'm Kathy Andrews Wright. Today, we're joined by Bob Gillespie with the Illinois Department of Natural Resources. Bob, can you give us a little bit of a background about your work with the DNR?
Certainly. I'm a grassland ecologist, and I'm the site manager at Prairie Ridge State Natural Area. And Prairie Ridge is the only location in the state that supports greater prairie chickens.
Historically, the greater prairie chicken was abundant in the American Midwest, and they once existed throughout much of Illinois. But I bet that most of our audience has not seen a greater prairie chicken. So maybe the place we should start our conversation today is with a brief history of the prairie chicken in Illinois.
Sure. The greater prairie chicken is really very indicative of our prairie state. And at the height of populations in our prairie state, prairie chickens occupied 92 of our 102 Illinois counties. So it was very prevalent historically. In 1818, Illinois became a state, and that was at settlement, essentially. And in 1860, we had our peak of abundance of greater prairie chickens in Illinois. So after settlement, we had a period of time where the population actually increased. So in 1860, we had a peak of 10 to 14 million birds that are known to have occurred in the state at that time. So that is a very, very significant population. But that did not last long. And after that peak, due to a mix of, heavy uses of grasslands, whether it was grazing or conversion to row crop agriculture, that peak dwindled off and has continued to do so as we use our landscape more and more intensively for agricultural production. Today, our landscape is extensively utilized with just some few grassland areas, Prairie Ridge in particular, that supports greater prairie chickens.
Well, thank you, Bob, for that fascinating history on the greater prairie chicken. We went from millions and millions of birds in the 1860s to just a couple hundred birds now today. And that means today that the greater prairie chicken is an Illinois endangered species. So a lot of people probably don't understand what exactly it means for a species to be declared an endangered species. Could you give us a little bit of information on what that entails?
Certainly. An endangered species is an organism that is at risk of imminent extinction. So endangerment is identified by the number of individuals that are perceived to remain in a population, or there are species that are listed due to a precipitous decline that's observed throughout their range. So for greater prairie chickens, the loss of habitat has been the overwhelming factor for the declines in our population and the endangerment of that species. So in Illinois today, we only have approximately 3,600 acres to 4,000 acres of high quality habitat that's currently occupied by GPCs. So that's in reality a very small acreage that supports a much reduced and endangered population.
Thanks for that answer, Bob. The Illinois Department of Natural Resources and the Illinois Endangered Species Protection Board have developed a species recovery plan for the prairie chicken. Would you explain what the purpose of a species recovery plan is for our viewers and briefly summarize the steps outlined for the recovery of the prairie chicken?
Sure. The recovery plan for the recovery of greater prairie chickens in Illinois was developed by Jeff Walk in 2004 with the help of many other collaborators, many other biologists and scientists. And that plan is a species recovery plan that identifies specific objectives and tasks to ensure the long-term viability of greater prairie chickens in Illinois. So it specifically describes the steps that are needed to bring greater prairie chickens back from endangerment to a more stable and safe situation. Okay, so the greater The recovery plan for Greater Prairie Chickens in Illinois identifies specific objectives and tasks to help this organism come back from the brink of extinction. Two, it identifies specific actions that should be taken if the population drops to a very precipitous level. And in this case, it describes translocations. And in Illinois, we've had several different episodes where we have conducted translocations from secure populations of greater prairie chickens and brought them to Illinois to augment our populations here and to support the genetic health of our population. And three, the plan specifies methodologies for enhancing and augmenting habitats to create habitat that is absolutely the best for greater prairie chicken recovery. So those are the three main aspects of that recovery plan.
Well, thank you for that, Bob. Researchers are an incredible partner in understanding both the health of the greater prairie chicken in Illinois and the population dynamics. And that came into play, especially with the translocation process, but researchers have been involved for many, many years. Can you please describe to us what some of the research projects are that have taken place with the prairie chicken, and what have we learned about the prairie chicken from that research?
Prairie Ridge is unique in that it is a case study in and of itself of a grassland area that is available in Illinois for researchers. We have a very small population of greater prairie chickens here, and that has lent the research to a long history of cutting-edge genetic research. Due to the isolated and critical size of our greater prairie chicken population, so we have learned much about inbreeding depression here at Prairie Ridge because our population is so small, our greater prairie chicken population is so small, and it is so isolated from other populations of greater prairie chickens. So there's no new greater prairie chickens coming in unless we translocate them. So they're very isolated. So it's essentially a small case study population. And inbreeding depression has taught us that a population, once it becomes so small, can become very genetically impoverished. And what that means is that its fitness of egg success or its reproductive potential declines in many ways. So we've learned lots from different genetic studies that have focused on our small population. We've also learned a lot from the different telemetry or radio tracking research that has been done on the area. And for me in particular, the telemetry has taught me a lot as an area manager about what I need to focus on to support the population of greater prairie chickens here. For instance, radio birds, we can identify what habitats they are using, where they spend their time, where the hens nest, where they take their broods, and we have an idea what areas on the sanctuary are most utilized, what habitats are preferred, and for me to be responsible for providing those habitats and those different resources to support the life histories of chickens, that's very important. So just as two examples, our genetic research on the area has been very, very pronounced. A lot of research on genetics has occurred. And then also our radio tracking has been very interesting as well.
So a huge amount of effort obviously goes into managing the property at Prairie Ridge State Natural Area to ensure that it can support the prairie chicken. But what are some of the types of management practices that are used there?
Prairie Ridge is very intensively managed, and it is intensively managed so we can provide the very optimum, very best possible grassland habitat for grassland wildlife, and in particular, greater prairie chickens. So a lot of our management is tailored to provide all sorts of different grassland habitats and different grassland structure. So we do lots of prescribed rotary mowing. And rotary mowing involves, you know, mowing the grass at different heights. We're not talking about mowing a yard, if you will, but we're varying the heights of the grasses because greater prairie chicken hens like just a specific structure to their grass. So we do a lot of rotary mowing for nesting. So the hen greater prairie chickens feel very comfortable. They are accepting of that grass structure. So that's very important. We do a lot of that. We also do a lot of rotary mowing for essentially brush control and exotic species control. So that's one aspect. We do a lot of prescribed burning on the site. We are constantly developing burn units and processing those burn units, and we do them throughout the year, which is unique. We have a spring burn program. We burn in the summer to some degree, and then we also burn in the fall. And then we also like to conduct some of our prescribed fires in the dead of winter when conditions are very mild for burning, especially when we're burning some of our very, you know, very tallest grass and most dynamic fuels. We also do a lot of meadow conversion and seeding and reestablishment of grasses, because over time, grass stands can decline depending on the species. And we plant all variety of different grasses, from smooth brome to red top to, you know, various warm season grasses, from little blue to big blue stem, et cetera, et cetera. We also do a lot of exotics control, whether it's the control of Serratia lespediza or Japanese honeysuckle or bush honeysuckle in our meadows or autumn olive. And with the exotics control comes brush control. And on our prairies today, we see a lot of green ash that's invading our meadows and other brushy species that are undesirable. And to have an open grassland requires quite a bit of brush control. So those are some things that that we do to manage our grassland here at Prairie Ridge.
Thank you, Bob. You know, on a personal note, I cherish that the fact that I have been able to go out on the leks during the booming season a few times in my life, and that resonating boom that just hits the center of your soul is so powerful, it's unforgettable. And I when I'm out there, I sit and I think, what was the Illinois landscape like back in 1860s, when there were 14, 16 million prairie chickens that are out there? Now, you grew up right there around that area, and you've had the fortunate opportunity your entire life to experience the prairie chickens, and now you work there. What an incredible experience you have. You must feel really fortunate to have had the opportunity to experience something that so few people have a chance to do in Illinois now.
Absolutely, with no doubt. Greater prairie chickens they're just marvelous animals and are to be cherished. They are very charismatic, and it is a joy to see them display on the booming grounds. And to me, really, their springtime song is kind of the anthem of the true prairie. Perhaps it's the anthem of our prairie state. They're just a phenomenal organism, like you say, Kathy.
I love that, the anthem of the prairie state. I have a separate question. So the pandemic is just causing everyone to stay home, but eventually, hopefully, people will be getting out and about again. When and where, if people wanted to come experience the prairie chicken for themselves, how could they do that?
Well, right now, during the pandemic, we are not conducting the blind viewing program that the Illinois Audubon Society has promoted in past years, simply because people are in very close proximity in the blinds. But greater prairie chickens can be viewed from the public roadways. We have some booming grounds that are viewable from the roadways themselves, which are completely accessible to the public. And then we will also have a portion of the area open for viewing from a distance. We call it our North Barn viewing location. And it is an area that birders can set up spotting scopes and view the birds with their binoculars and hear those springtime courtship calls. And it's a good opportunity for people to get out and socially distance properly. And that will be the opportunity this spring.
Wonderful. Glad to hear that. Well, thanks, Bob, for joining us and providing an overview of the Illinois endangered greater prairie chicken. Remember, viewers, if you have questions about other Illinois wildlife, or if you have ideas for future question and answer sessions, please send those in to the Wildlife Illinois website, and we'll see you next time.